Czech Republic. We are quite close to the city center in an old building that used to be a headquarters of a propaganda newspaper in the old days, Red Justice. Now we are about 20 people and we were happy to join the building early on because we were able to get a lot of space, and as people were joining we were able to just get more space that we needed. We started the company as musicians and we basically were not able to afford to buy synths, so we started to build our own. And sort of this story is still continuing, and all we ever did was for us. We both came from the art school and like all we learned is either from the internet or from like the generation of our fathers.
What is really important for us and what was always thing we liked about Bastl approach or our approach into making instruments was that we are trying to work with the people from here. We have different, so to say, divisions. Like there are people asking us to join and they are joining the crew and we are growing and growing and we can always find something to do, because then we can finally, with somebody who understands wood, we can finally start to do something beautiful like wooden knobs or like these details. And so there are people with different interests, different skill set, different experience coming. And we are like slowly growing and it's changing our portfolio of skills, what we can do. Most important is, of course, having people who are passionate about like bringing ideas, like developing some projects by themselves and then bring into the pool.
We started to be interested really in the modular sense. So basically, we developed a whole range of Eurorack products which can form a complete system. And so for the Eurorack modules, we basically used the CNC machine that we had in the house earlier to prototype the panels, just to see that everything fits and everything is perfect. And the first moment we saw how it looks, we just fell in love with it, and it took us a while to figure out to really make it right, to find the right wood, how to make the varnish and the printing perfect, but I think now we've really achieved that. But that doesn't mean it's like the only focus. We make these tabletop instruments like the micro granny, or we have also some standalone things like the castle, and we also work with Peter Edwards from Casper Electronics, who's making this beautiful art object synthesizers, which are like very creative.
I chose to move here a year ago. I was living in Holland at the time, and I met with Ondřej and Václav, and I was really excited about what Bastl is doing, and they have a really similar energy to me, which is really about sort of the lifestyle around what we're doing, not just making an instrument with a couple features, but really like, why do you want to play music? Why do you want to explore these things? So it seemed like an adventure worth taking.
Bastl Castle is a lo-fi digital pocket-sized modular synthesizer which runs on 3 AA batteries.
Thank you.
I'm not sure if it's a good strategy to make funny videos about the products, but I'm sure that we are enjoying that, and that's the most important part. And I'm not sure if it sells, but like Bastl Instruments, it's not a brand without faces, without like just a logo or something. It's us like doing stuff, and we would like to communicate that we love what we do.
The click. And you can also use that damn reset button to trigger anything in your modular.
We like to have fun.
We run a little showroom synth store called Noise Kitchen. And it's like a hub for people who make music that they can go there, meet there. This really skilled and talented musician working there. Heard a lot, and they can talk to him, learn something from him. He's doing weekly workshops also about synthesis and electronic music making in general. And I think that's very important to just provide like a meeting spot for the electronic music in the city. Of course, we'd like to make new products, but I think the main way how we are growing at this point is the number of different activities that we are doing. So we started to roast our own coffee, we make events in the city, we also make a little festival. Recently we started to release music, our own label, Nona Records. And soon we would like to also make some kind of podcast or streaming. So there is more of energy going into the music making way. And I think that's the most exciting part for me to see like where we grow in that aspect.